Hi everyone, it's Teenage Mental Lover, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about eating disorder representation in movies and short films. So as the years went on, I feel as though eating disorder movies and short films have become kind of romanticized, but also not only romanticized, but they've always been kind of less in representation. So for example, you have To the Bone, Black Swan, Insatiable. You have a ton of short films, but none of them really show people of color or people of any other ethnicity. And I don't want to be controversial, but white people are not the only ones who experience eating disorders. So when I see that, it kind of just like rubs me the wrong way, because it feels as though, where's representation? And I feel like this happens a lot of times in Hollywood, and when they want something to really capture an audience, I feel like they go one route and there's so many other routes they can go. Firstly, when they're showing an eating disorder, especially anorexia or bulimia, they usually show someone who is really skinny, which, okay, hear me out here. Yes, I know an eating disorder is usually someone who's struggling with eating. However, usually when you're struggling with anorexia or bulimia, the kind of stereotypical person is someone who is skinny. I'm not gonna lie on that one. However, people don't really have to be skinny to be going through an eating disorder. You can be overweight and going through an eating disorder. You could be a normal weight and going through an eating disorder. I don't know why people, especially directors, movie producers, people in Hollywood, feel the need to make anorexia surround a skinny white girl. Like, it's just, that's not all, you know? And usually they're either in a sport or ballet, for example, or they're just, you know, really depressed, sad, pale, white, closed off from their family, or incredibly obsessed with perfectionism. Another example is in the show Red Band Society, we have Emma Choda, and Emma is a skinny white girl. Like, it's just, it's giving no representation, and then the insy tiny little bit of representation there is in To the Bone, where the only person of color is a black girl who is overweight and suffers from binge eating. So I don't like that, mainly because I want more representation. I want to see, even though it's sad, yes, I know it's sad, but I want to see people of different skin tones. I want to see people of different body types going through these eating disorders. Like, why are we only seeing one type of person? It's kind of sad. And it's kind of stems back to, like, for example, of course you can't compare an eating disorder to other mental health struggles. And you can't compare an eating disorder to like a popular girl stereotype or whatever. But I'm going to do it really quick. Sorry, but I'm going to do it. Because, for example, when you're looking at movies and you see like the popular girl or the girl that every guy loves, it's usually a blonde white girl. So then when you go back and you see like someone who suffers from an eating disorder is usually a skinny white girl, and it's giving the same kind of feeling. Like, why is the girl who everyone always loves and everyone always thinks is cool is of the same demographic, and then maybe she beneath the surface suffers from an eating disorder, and when you go to eating disorder movies, it's usually a skinny white girl. It's weird. It's getting a little weird, and they keep making more and more and more movies on throughout the years continuously, and many more short films. There are tons of short films. If you just type in eating disorder short films in YouTube, you'll find millions. You'll literally find millions. However, where's the diversity in it? You won't find that in millions. You'll find that in maybe one or two videos, maybe even three or four at most. It's getting sad. It's getting really sad, and I just feel that needs to be fixed. And I'm not saying that, oh yes, I want people to suffer, I want to see sadness. No, I just want to see representation, because there are people out there who are overweight, struggling with anorexia. There are people who are out there who are black, Hispanic, Asian, any other ethnicity other than Caucasian who are suffering from eating disorders. There are men out there who are suffering from eating disorders. That's another thing I could go into, the gender aspect. So just give more representation is all we're asking. Thank you. Bye.